Hello everyone, welcome to my new video. From the description and the video, you all are aware that I am in Aizwan, the capital of Mizoram. The video is on a continuation of my 60-day Northeast India ride, where I was exploring Northeastern India on a rented Honda Activa. In this video, I will be sharing my ride from Silchar in Assam to Aizwal in Mizoram. I will also share the information about the inner line permit for Mizoram, the condition of roads, and other necessary details that can help travelers to plan a trip to Mizoram. You can also find the link or blog post in the description, which will provide you a detailed explanation of my today's ride. Meanwhile, if you haven't seen my previous videos of my ride in Northeast, do check them on my YouTube channel. So let us start. After back-to-back ride from Kaziranga to Haflong and then from Haflong to Silchar, I was exhausted. I rode around 500 km on some of the best and the good roads of Northeast, and therefore I decided to take a 2 days rest in Silchar. I had already covered Meghalaya and certain part of Assam before arriving in Silchar, and now I was confused which state I should visit next. From Silchar, both Agartala and Aizwal are easily accessible. So I was not able to figure out which state I should aim next. Finally, I decided to explore Mizoram and visit Tripura later. From Silchar, Aizwal is around 180 km and Google Maps suggested 7 hours to reach Aizwal. It was fine for me as I had dedicated an entire day for today's ride. So I started my ride. In this video, you can see a well-paved straight road surrounded by rice field on both the sides. Since Silchar lies on the plains of Barak River, the road are in good shape and any motorcycle rider would love this stretch. The road connecting Silchar to Aizwal is also known as National Highway 306, and the road is in good condition, at least as per the standard of Northeast India. In fact, I enjoyed my ride from Silchar to a town called Bagha. It is a flat road and I hardly faced any issues. As the Assam-Mizoram border started approaching, the road transformed into a hilly one. From now on, I had to take extra precaution at the bends. The Assam-Mizoram border passes through Waringate, a checkpoint, and here traveler can get ILP for Mizoram. ILP stands for Inner Line Permit. The ILP is an official travel document issued by state government to allow travel of an Indian citizen into a protected area for a limited period. It is mandatory for Indian citizens as well as for foreigners to take ILP before visiting these protected areas. Currently, travelers visiting Northeast India have to apply ILP for visiting Mizoram, Nagaland, Arunachal Pradesh and Manipur. I took around 2 hours from Silchar to reach Waringate and then I applied for a 15 days ILP. I was planning to explore entire Mizoram and therefore I thought 15 days is a sufficient time. At Waringate, one can get ILP after providing a valid ID proof, which can be your Aadhaar card, driving license or passport, providing 2 passport size photo and paying a small fee. If you have all the documents in place, you can get ILP in 30 to 45 minutes. Once I got my ILP, I was ready to enter into Mizoram. From Waringate, Aizwal is around 130 km. The route passes through small town and village markets. The biggest city in between Silchar and Aizwal is Kolsib, which is about 50 km from Waringate. Kolsib is best place where one can stop for lunch or tea breaks, as it is the district headquarter and it has decent shops and restaurants. My Mizoram trip also coincided with state's general election and I noticed many vehicles and security personnel travelling on election duty. By the time I crossed Kolsib, Aizwal was only 80 kilometers and I had plenty of time, so I took multiple photography breaks. Throughout the video, I will be sharing photos of highway and markets which I crossed during my ride. The roads in Mizoram is a combination of good and bad patches. As most of the state fall under the dense cover of forest and hill, the construction of road is a mammoth task. Yet from my experience of 10 days ride in Mizoram, I can say that they are drivable. I am not sure about the monsoon season as the region received some of the highest rainfall in the country. So there are chances that the condition of road deteriorates as the monsoon arrives. Also, the road connecting Silchar to Aizwal is one of the most important roads in Mizoram as most of the freight transport takes place through this road, so it is in good shape compared with other parts of Mizoram. After crossing North Khwankui, there are two routes to reach Aizwal. One is the National Highway 306 and the second is State Highway 6. Google Maps suggested taking State Highway 6 and I was confused whether I should carry on National Highway, which is a more reliable, or a State Highway. Finally, I decided to follow Google's instruction and from the divergence, I took State Highway 6 and continued my journey. The state highway is narrower than the national route and initially I thought I had made a mistake, but as the journey progressed, the route became scenic. Moreover, there was hardly any traffic. The road reminded me of my trip from Haflong to Silchar, with the only difference that the condition was good, unlike Haflong Silchar where it took me 6 hours to cover 100 km. One advantage of taking state highway over the national highway was
that it passes through a peak, which is the highest point on the Silchar-Aizwal route. I found the pronunciation of the peak difficult, so I am mentioning its name. The peak lies at an elevation of 1500 meters above sea level and provides a panoramic view of Lushai Hills. From here, Aizwal is only 22 km and I had plenty of time. From the peak, I got a glimpse of forest density in Mizoram and the sunset made it a memorable experience. I stayed at the peak for around 30 minutes and later I continued my journey towards Aizwal.
Aizwal, this route, right?
Aizwal?
Yeah. As Aizwal started approaching, there was a gradual change in the landscape. Now there were no more trees and empty roads, but they were replaced by buildings and chaotic streets. After a few kilometers of ride, I reached Darplang. Darplang is a hill overlooking Aizwal city and it provides a great view of Aizwal city, especially in the night. There are many more points in Aizwal where one can get a panoramic view of Aizwal, but Darplang has its own charm. There are a few more places to explore in Darplang, which I will cover in my next video in places to visit in Aizwal. I reached Aizwal around 4 PM and to my surprise, I hardly noticed any traffic on the roads. When I checked with local, they informed me that today is Sunday, so the majority of Mizoram remained closed, including hotels, restaurants and petrol pumps. In Mizoram, the majority of population follows Christianity. Therefore, people visit church to offer prayer on Sunday. I faced issue with finding an accommodation as most of the hotels were either closed or there was no one on the reception to help. After meandering for about an hour in the city, I was able to find one hotel and I booked a room. Therefore, if you are planning to visit Aizwal or any other part of Mizoram, kindly make an advance booking if you are arriving on Sunday. Once I found the accommodation, I concluded my today's ride from Silchar to Aizwal. I wanted to explore the city but I was running low on food, so I avoided riding. I explored Aizwal the next day. Thanks for watching. If you like my video, do like and subscribe. I am uploading videos of my solo ride in Northeast India. And in my next video, I will be sharing information about places to visit in Aizwal and about my future trip in Medina. Till then, stay safe. Thanks.